Alright, so good afternoon to those who are here already. So, can you guys hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
Yes,
sir.
sir.
That's good.
Yes, sir.
So, good afternoon to all of you. Wait lang natin yung iba. Anyway, very, very short meeting lang.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let's wait one more minute. Baka may humabol pa. So there were two who have just joined. Okay, that's good. May umalis na isa. Kanina 14 na tayo ah, tapos naging 13 na lang. Ayan. Oh, yun. 15. Alright, that's good. So, oh, wow. Naging 16. Okay, so I guess nandito na lahat. Alright. So, let's start now our short discussion. Okay. So, module 1 will talk about operational amplifiers. Okay, or in other words, we call this one op-amps. Is there someone here who has an idea what is an op-amp or where do we use such thing? Op-amps or operation amplifiers. Anyone? So it's like all of you are new to the word op-amps, or maybe you guys have already heard of it but doesn't really learn what is the meaning or what is op-amps for. Am I right? First time?
Yes, sir. It is used for capacitors and resistors, sir.
Used for capacitors and resistors? Para saan? Yeah, it requires
voltage.
For
voltage.
For voltage. So what will happen to that voltage? Wala. So basically, from the word itself, amplifier, so it amplifies the voltage or the current that will go inside of it. Okay. So the first thing that you need to know about op-amps is it has a high gain. So when I say high gain, so it can transform a very low voltage into a high voltage. Okay. So yun na siguro yung pinaka-generic or pinaka-general definition ng op-amps. Alright, so without a further delay, so we should talk about amplifier first before getting to the word op-amps. Okay, so amplifier. So as you can see right here, we have a current or a voltage wherein once it passes through this device or an amplifier, it will, you know, enlarge or it will make it larger, right? So sometimes it's 10 times larger, it's 100 times larger, sometimes even 100,000 times larger or even 1 million times larger, okay? So that's how an amplifier works. So this kind of a device is mostly used in speakers. Okay, so it converts that small voltage into a higher voltage to provide a higher decibels. Okay, or sound. So going to the operational amplifier, it is being represented by this makahiga, okay, horizontal or basta nakahiga, hindi ko lang paano explain, nakahigang triangle. Okay, this like this one. And then it has two inputs, and then we have here the voltage source positive and then voltage source negative, and then the output. Okay. So again, as I have said a while ago, op amps is a high gain. Okay. So when you say high gain, it converts this one into 100,000 times or 1 million times from the original source. Well, this is only applicable if we have an open loop circuit. But in reality, we don't use this one, okay? Because this one is too high and it's uncontrollable, okay? It's hard to maintain. So that is why we only have closed loop in real world, okay? So itong output na to, to have a closed loop na tinatawag natin, so magkakaroon tayo ng feedback. This output will go to our input. So I drop those two. So magkakaroon tayo ng discussion kung saan siya pupunta. So pwedeng negative, pwedeng sa positive. Okay? So operational amplifiers are linear devices that have all the properties required for nearly ideal DC operational amplification and are therefore used extensively in signal conditioning, filtering, or to perform mathematical operations such as adding, or that's the one that we are now calling summing amplifier, or subtract, or the differential amplifier, or even integration or differentiation. So take note, differentiation is different from subtract or differential. So that is why we've used subtract instead of differential. So baka malito kayo, differential tapos differentiation parang parehas lang. Okay, differentiate na lang yung two voltage. No, okay? So differential is different into differentiation. Okay? So ito yung magka-partner. Integration, saka differentiation, at saka add, saka subtraction. Okay? So basically, this is what we use as a fundamentals analog device before until now, actually. Okay? So kung may makita ka mga gadgets na ganun wherein it can do summation gamit ang mga buttons, so pwedeng yung buttons na yun is nagtatransmit ng voltage or current. And then, kung ilang beses mo siyang pindot, or pwede namang via, ano man tawag dito? Via, ano tawag dito sa photoresistor, parang ganun. Pwede photo through or via photoresistor. Ano ba yun? Photoresistor, yung napipihit. Okay, so pwede mo controlin yung voltage na pumapasok. What? Hindi eh, photoresistor is for light. Ano bang tawag doon? Yung meron tatlong pin, tapos pwede mong kontrolin. Anyone? Makalimutan yung pangalan. Para siyang radio. Ano yan?
Potentiometer.
Potentiometer. Potentiometer yun. Okay. So pwede yung ganun. Okay. So kung meron ganun, so, and then, naglalabas ang nag-display siya ng let's say, addition, subtraction, integration, or differentiation, ang fundamental sa ginamit doon is operational amplifier. Okay? Alright. So, the first thing that you need to know about operational amplifier is basically, okay, lahat ng operational amplifiers are differential amplifiers. Okay? By default. Kasi kung papansin niyo, it has two inputs. And then, ang mangyari kasi niyan, kung bakit nasabing differential amplifier, lalo na kapag hindi pantay yung input natin sa positive at saka sa negative, ang ginagawa niyan is i-differentiate niya na kagad. Or, yun, magsusubtract na kagad. May own calculation or may formula kung paano natin makocompute yung voltage na lalabas dito. Okay? Pero, kung gusto natin ng isa lang, okay, we call that one non-inverting or the inverting op-amps. So for now, we'll discuss non-inverting op-amps. So when I say non-inverting, our voltage input, okay, our voltage input will go through positive pin. Okay, kaya nga tinawag na non-inverting eh. So take note, we have two pins. The one is negative and the other one is positive. So if it's non-inverting, your voltage input should go through positive. Okay, and then kagaya ng sabi ko kanina, open loop, masyadong mataas yun. Ito, meron siyang gain ng 100,000 or umabot pa ng 1 million. That is only applicable for open loop. Okay? So, hindi siya ganun ka-useful, lalo na sobrang taas na nun, okay? So, that is why we have this closed loop wherein magkakaroon tayo ng feedback resistor para papasok ulit siya dito. So, parang may looping siya dyan para makontrol natin, okay? Hindi siya ganun kataas. Yes, masasacrifice yung potential na mag-create siya ng mataas na voltage, pero controllable naman na siya, okay? So, unlike before, nag-range siya ng 100,000 to 1 million. Ngayon, pwedeng times 10 na lang. Like, your 1 volt will become 10 volts. Your 2 volts will become 20 volts. Like, napaka-ideal niya na, kumbaga. So, yun yung pinakagusto nating ma-attain, which is a closed-loop circuit, just like this one, okay? So, we have here a feedback resistor and then input resistor. So, where am I now? So, in this configuration, the input voltage signal or the Vin is applied directly to the non-inverting, which is the positive pin. Okay? Input terminal, which means that the output gain of the amplifier becomes positive. So, take note, if it's non-inverting, so whatever is the side, eh, hindi naman sinabing porket non-inverting lahat na ng output is positive. Okay? That's a no-no. Kung ano yung sign ng voltage input mo, yun din yung magiging sign ng output mo. So if I have a negative voltage input, then I will also have a negative voltage output. Pero mostly, of course, in reality, hindi naman negative yung ginagamit natin. Okay. So ginagamit natin is positive voltage. So this one is positive value only. Okay. So this one is in contrast to inverting amplifier, wherein, again, in real world, ang ginagamit natin is positive. So kapag ginamit natin yung positive sa inverting, ang result is negative. Pero dito, sa non-inverting, whatever is the sign of your voltage input, then it will stay as it is. Okay? So the result of this, that the output signal is in phase with the input signal. So kung positive, positive din siya. Okay, pareha sila ng phasing. Pero doesn't mean na equal sila ng phasing. Pareha sila ng phasing, pero hindi same yung output, okay, or yung value. So we have here the formula if ever we have this kind of circuit, okay? So kapag ganito yung circuit diagram, then we can simplify this one as having this formula. So Vout is equal to 1 plus RF, feedback resistor, divided by the R1 or Rin, okay, times the Vin. Okay, so para ma-appreciate nyo itong formula na ito kung bakit or paano ba siya gumagana, so we'll be having an example. So example of non-inverting amplifier, so we have a given here. So we have 9 kilo ohms for the feedback resistor and then 1 kilo ohms for the Rin. Okay, and then 1 volt for the voltage input. Okay, so find Vout. So here's the solution using the formula that showed to you a while ago, this one. So V out is equal to 1 plus RF divided by R1 times V in. So basically, lalagay mo lang yung mga values. Ano ba yung RF? Ano ba yung Rin? Ano ba yung V in? Okay. So RF is 9K. And then divided by 1K, which is our Rin, times V in, which is 1. So if you're going to simplify this one, then 9K divided by 1K is 9. Okay. Simply cancel yung K. So 1 plus 9 is equal to 10. And then 10 times 1 is 10. So as you can see right here, from 1 volt, it became 10 volts. Okay? So, ganun na siya ka-effective as an amplifier. Okay? Or this one is non-inverting amplifier. Okay? Hindi lang, kasi maraming klase ng amplifier. So we have to be specific. This one is only applied to non-inverting amplifier. This kind of formula. Okay, so we have a different formula for inverting amplifier, differential amplifier, and then summing amplifier. Okay. So did you guys get it so far for the non-inverting amplifier?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All right. Yes, sir. So kung sakaling nabibitin kayo dito, meron actually a step-by-step derivation. Like for example, nandito yung voltage natin. Okay? Saan na siya napunta? Okay, ano na yung voltage niya mula dito hanggang dito? Or dito hanggang dito, ano na yung current niya? Okay, so may derivation to dun sa pinagkuhanan ko. So, nilagay ko sa reference. Ibigay ko na lang sa inyo mamaya. Pero, hindi naman siya ganun ka-importante. Pero gusto nyo na malaman kung saan napunta yung voltage up to this point, up to that point. So, meron doon, step by step. So, tignan nyo na lang sa reference ko mamaya. Ang ginawa ko kasi is nag-straight to the point na ako. So, kapag meron kayong ganitong circuit, actually, ganito naman lahat. Ganito naman mostly lahat ang circuit ng non-inverting amplifier. So, ito yung formula niya talaga. Okay. Para hindi na magulo, hindi na paligoy-ligoy pa. Right? So, the next thing that you need to do is verify whether this one is doable in LTSpice or no. So, yes, this is doable since nagawa ko naman na siya. So, gawa na lang ulit tayo ng bago. So, na yung circuit natin. Okay. Halitan ko na lang ito. Alright. So, first, we need an op-amp. Okay? So, para makakuha kayo ng op-amp, punta lang kayo dito sa mga components or click F2. Okay? So, magpapakita na itong mga components. So, dito, merong op-amps. So, double-click nyo lang yan. And then, magpapakita lahat ng klase ng op-amps. So, napakarami nyan. Okay? Pero, hindi ito kompleto. Okay? Meron at meron pa rin kulang dito sa library ng LTSpice. Okay? So, sa ngayon, ang gagamitin natin is itong universal op-amp 2. Okay? So, this is just a generic op-amp. Meron pang mga ibang klase na mas maganda dito. Pero ito na lang muna since simple lang naman yung gagawin natin. Okay? So, click nyo lang yan and then click OK. Okay? And then, kung papansin ninyo, okay, sir, ba't parang may nadagdag itong positive side sa taas at saka negative side sa baba? Okay. So, don't worry, didiscuss ko kung para saan itong nasa taas at saka nasa baba mamaya. Okay? We call this one real voltage. Okay? So, parang ito yung magiging peak-to-peak voltage natin mamaya. Pero mamaya pa rin. Papakita ko sa inyo kung ano yung magiging difference. Alright. So, the next thing that we'll be needing is two resistors, the Rin and then the RF. So, R, para lang sa shortcut ng R. So, para i-rotate, control R. Okay? Can you guys follow? Pwede nyo na rin gawin habang ginagawa kung gusto nyo gawin na rin yan. So, hindi na mahalaging arrangement. Ang mahalaga is alam mo na ito yung value nito is ganito and then value nito is ganyan. Okay, so, since example lang naman siya, hindi ko na siya in-arrange. So, ito yung RF natin. And then, ito naman yung R1. Okay, so, hindi ko muna papalag yung pangalan. Lagi muna natin yung value. So, RF is 9K and then Rin is 4K. So, RF, 9K. So, right-click mo lang mismo yung resistor para magpakita to. Itong value ng resistance. And this one is 1K. Alright? So, connect muna natin. Ito yung feedback resistor natin. There you go. So, from here, pwede na natin palitan para hindi kayo masyado malito. Okay? So, right-click mo lang din yung R1. From there, you can now change R1 to RF. Same with R2. So this one is RE or R1. R1 ba? RE. Okay. And then, the next thing that you'll be needing is this one, the voltage input. So from here, kukuha na tayo ng voltage source. So click F2 again and then type voltage. So pwede nyo namang hanapin isa-isa pero sa akin kasi tinatype ko na lang para mas mabilis. Okay, so voltage. And then, okay. Okay. So, lalagay ko lang siya dito. So, check the polarity. So, positive to positive. Okay. And then, our Vin is 1 volt. Okay. And then, dapat meron tayong ground, of course. Okay. So, ito, nakakonect din siya sa ground. So, kung i-simulate nyo na to, wala kayong makuha ang result. Actually, magkakaroon kayo ng error. So, set mo na natin. So, 50 milliseconds lang yung running time. Check natin kung walang error. Uy, walang error. Tama ba? Check natin yung result. 0.5 millivolts. Okay, so yun yung kulang. Okay, wala siyang error, pero kulang. Kasi dapat, kapag kinumpute natin yung Vout, dapat ang makukuha natin is 10 volts, kagaya nito. Pero dito, ang nakukuha natin is 0.5 millivolts. So that is why, ito na yung magiging usage ng rail voltage natin, yung positive at saka negative side. So ito yung mga sinauna, okay, kung bakit meron ganito. Ito yung mga sinaunang amplifier na meron pang rail voltage, yung positive at saka negative. So magkahiwalay. Okay? So ito, yung positive side, ito yung peak voltage ng positive mo. And then yung negative is yun naman yung peak voltage ng negative mo. Okay? So palakihan ko lang para mas makita nyo. So from here, maglalagay tayo ngayon ng peak-to-peak voltage natin. So yun yung magiging reference voltage kung ano yung magiging output natin. Okay, so voltage. So check nyo lang ulit yung polarity. So dapat nakatapat dito. Positive to positive. There you go. And then dapat ito is nakakonect din sa ground. So clinic ko lang yung G, tatapot ko siya sa negative, and then there you go. So connected na siya sa ground. The same with the other side. So voltage. So dito, another trick. So pwedeng hindi nyo na-flip, pero pwede rin naman kung gusto nyo i-flip. Kapag clinic nyo, tapos pinalitan yung value na ito, by default, negative na siya kasi yun yung nakatapat pataas. Okay, or yun yung nakakonect rather dun sa voltage natin. Pero kapag nakaganito, okay, kailangan natin palitan yung sign. So gamitin ko na lang pa para hindi kayo malito. Nasa taas yung positive. Then connect natin. So ito dapat, kunyari gusto natin ng 15 peak na positive and then negative 15 na peak na negative. So dito right click lang and then 15, positive 15 volts niyan. And then dito naman, since yung polarity niya is positive to negative and then kailangan natin ng negative 15 volts, kailangan natin maglagay ng sign na negative. And then, right? And then, connected din dapat ito. Okay? So, ito, makikita nyo lang yung difference kapag AC mismo yung input natin. Pero since DC siya, so flat lang yan. Okay? So, run lang natin ulit para ma-refresh. So, check natin itong mga values. Tama kaya? Alright, so check natin. So there you go. So meron na tayong reading ng 9.999. So para mas makuha nyo yung accurate na value net or result, click nyo lang mismo yung VN002 or kung ano man yung pangalan na nagpakita dyan. So in my case, yan. So 9.999918. So bakit ganun? Bakit hindi eksaktong 10? Kasi, again, in reality, yung wire natin, hindi porket wire siya, wala na siyang kinukuhang resistance. So meron pa rin resistance yung mga wires. So napakaganda ng simulator na LTSpice kasi medyo makatotohanan yung nakukuha nating mga values. Unlike ito, sa computation natin, it's exactly 10 volts. Unlike in LTSpice, we've got 9.9999. Alright? Did you guys get it so far?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Alright. So again, sure. Kasi nung sabi ko kanina, ito yung magiging reference nyo dun sa magiging output nyo. So kung papansin niyo yung result na nakuha natin out of this voltage input and then yung mga value ng resistance natin is 10 rather. So what if ginawa kong 8 volts lang to, itong positive supply natin? So anong magiging result sa tingin nyo? What do you guys think? Ano magiging value ng Vout natin? Anyone wants to guess? 8. So coming from Mr. Goliden, actually you are correct. Kasi ngayon yung peak voltage na natin. So Run ko lang ulit. And then there you go. So, 7.99. So, hindi siya eksaktong 8 again, pero at least sobrang dikit. 7.99. Okay? So, ito yung nagiging limiter natin. Okay? Itong rail voltage natin. So, kung kailangan naman natin ng negative, so, pwede naman. Palitan mo lang to into negative. Okay? So, ano yung sign ng voltage input mo, magiging negative din yun. So, from 7.99, it will become negative 7. Ah, hindi. 15 pa rin pala to. Gawin kong 8. 7.99. Oops. Negative 8. There you go. So, eto. So, we now have a negative 7.99. So, again, whatever is the sign of your voltage input, then that will be the dominant sign. So, meron na tayong voltage input na negative 1. Okay, so magiging negative na rin yung result. If this one is positive, then this one will become positive also. Or the result will become positive. There you go. So, 7.99. Alright, so nagets nyo so far kung paano gumagana yung non-inverting amplifier natin.
Yes, sir.
That's good. Alright, so moving on. Okay, very good. So moving on, if we have non-inverting, we also have inverting amplifier. Okay? Or inverting op-amps. So, ito yung circuit natin. Okay, so mamaya explain ko kung anong nabago, ano yung parang pinagkaiba nila. So, in this inverting amplifier circuit, the operational amplifier is connected with feedback to produce a closed loop operation. So, same pa rin. Meron pa rin tayong closed loop operation. So, papansin ninyo, same lang actually. Itong reference voltage natin is nasa taas pa rin, which is connected to the negative. And then, our Rin is still on the upper side. Okay? And then, so when dealing with operational amplifiers, there are two very important rules to remember about inverting amplifiers. Okay? So again, this is only applicable to inverting amplifiers and differential amplifier. So, yung iba, iba na yung rule nila. So, the first two rules, or yung pinaka-importanteng rules, is no current flows into the input terminal. Okay? So what are those terminals? So we have the V2 and then the V1. Walang dumadali na kuryente doon. So actually parang ako din kanina nagtataka ako kasi imposible naman. Okay. Kasi input 'yun eh. Tapos saan napupunta yung voltage natin? Papakita ko mamaya kung parang bigla na lang naglaho. Okay. Biglang nawala yung current natin mula sa point na to, mula papunta dito. Kahit dito rin, wala ring voltage dito. Or wala rin current dito. So, either of those two. So, walang current. Pero, meron na tayong current mismo dito sa output. Pero wala sa input. Okay. So, di ko alam kung bakit ganun. So, however, in real world, op-amp circuits, both of these rules are slightly broken. So, totoo to, pero meron pa rin konti. Since, yun nga, meron at meron pa rin dumadali. Pero sobrang liit. Or it's negligible na kumbaga. Pero meron pa rin, not actually zero, pero meron, pero sobrang liit na lang. Okay? So this is because the junction of the input and feedback signal X is at the same potential as the positive input which is at 0 volts. Okay? Kung papansin ninyo, ito kasing ground natin is connected din dun sa voltage input natin. So that is why parang instead of going to have a clockwise flow of current. So, yung iba napupunta dun sa reverse, okay? Which is yung virtual earth natin. And then, zero ground junction and virtual earth. So, because of this virtual earth node, the input resistance of the amplifier is equal to the value of the input resistor. So, parang may effect siya kasi connected or iisa lang yung connection ng ground nila which is a virtual earth. So Rin and the closed loop gain of the inverting amplifier can be set by the ratio of the two external resistors, which is the Rin and then the Rf. And then again, here's the formula for the inverting amplifier. So initially, what we're trying to get here is the gain or the voltage gain. And then this one can be derived by having this one, Vout divided by VE. And then from here, you can have another derivation, which is now equal to negative RF divided by RE. So again, ito, my derivation to, okay, dun sa reference sa pinagkuhanan ko. So pwede nyong tignan kung paano tayo nag-come up with this V out divided by V in and then negative RF divided by RE. So since ang kinukuha lang naman natin sa inverting or sa amplifier, okay, is just the V out, so we can derive this one or we can simplify this one into this one. So V out is equal to negative RF divided by R in times V in. Alright, so ito yung magiging formula mo kung ganito na ganito yung circuit ng inverting op amps mo. Okay? So ano na yung difference nila, sir, sa circuit? So parehas lang actually, nandito pa rin yung R in natin, nandito pa rin yung RF. And then ang pinagbago lang is nandito na ngayon yung voltage input natin. Okay? So connected na siya sa inverting pin. Kaya nga tinawag na inverting eh. So kapag non-inverting, nakakonect yung voltage input natin sa positive. And it if it's inverting, then nakakonect naman yung Vin natin sa negative. Okay? And then since wala nang connection to, so grounded na lang to, yung positive pin natin. And then yun lang naman yung nabago. So same pa rin naman. Okay, so let's have an example. So we're going to use the same value. Oops. Mali. So di ko napalitan. So ang gagamitin nating circuit is this one. Okay? So grounded na dapat to and then nandito na yung voltage input natin. Okay? So ito is sa non-inverting. Okay? Ito yung gagamitin nating circuit. So anyway, so using this formula, V out is equal to negative RF divided by R in times V in. Okay? We'll be having this result. So RF is 9K again. And then R in is 1K, and then V in is 1. So whatever's the result, so 9K divided by 1K is 9 times 1. This is still 9, and then multiply by negative. So negative 9 volts. So from the word itself, inverting, the original 1 volt will become negative. So it is not in phase, but the opposite phase. So yung positive mo na sine wave, kapag sa output, negative yun. Yung negative mo na input sa inverting, positive yun. Okay. So kabaliktaran. So kung meron kang input na negative, you'll have a positive output. Okay? And then, yeah. So ang papansin ninyo, another thing maybe na makikita nyo is dito, merong plus 1, pero dito wala. Okay? So yung plus 1, applicable lang yun sa non-inverting. And then itong walang plus 1, ang napalit naman is yung negative sign. Applicable yan sa inverting. Okay? Alright, so 4 minutes na lang natitira. So I think hindi natin matatapos to kasi i-introduce ko pa yung mga laboratories nyo mamaya. So puputulin ko na ngayon and then magkikreate na lang ulit ako ng bagong link and then join na lang ulit kayo doon para doon na natin itutuloy. Okay, para hindi maganda yung or hindi pangit yung pagkaputol ng meeting natin. Okay, so goodbye for now and then see you on part 2. Okay? So there were... Goodbye.